गुड आफ्टरनून टू वंडन। या यू कैन हैव ए लुक इन टू दिस पिक्चर, व्हाट्स हैपनिंग हियर, कैन समवन एक्सप्लेन? यू कैन सी द चाइल्ड इज ट्राइंग टू क्रॉस दिस रोड विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम एडल्ट, राइट, विद द हेल्प ऑफ हिज पेरेंट. You want to cross the road with the help of someone. For example, you want to replace this parent with robot. How that can do? I want to replace this adult with some robot. I am expecting robot to help this kid to cross the road. Then how that can do? What are the requirements for that robot?
Sensors, sir.
Yeah, sensors that require, right? What kind of sensors that requires here? See, you can have a look into this one. What the people are doing is, first, this person is trying to see on the road whether some vehicles are coming towards them and with what velocity. Whether they are coming with high speed or whether that vehicle is coming with low speed, they are doing all those estimations, and based on those estimations they are trying to cross the road. If that vehicle is coming with less velocity and if this is a little bit far away from them, they will try to cross the road without any problem. They need some estimation, right? For that, this person is using eyes in order to notice whether vehicle is coming or not, right? With the help of eyes. Sensors in this case are eyes. Suppose you want to replace this person with a robot, then what should be those sensors? Yeah, which sensor is responsible for vision? Okay, someone answered ultrasonic. See, ultrasonic sensors, they can find obstacles, right? Some principles similar to radars based on reflections. They'll try to find whether some obstacle is there nearby them or not. But it can't justify that whether that is a car or whether that is some person or whether that obstacle is a tree. You don't know anything, right? Yes. I want to replace eyes with some sensor. Eyes for human beings are helpful for vision. Now I want to provide some vision to robot. Yeah, what is the replacement for eyes? It's a camera, right? Is it okay? Can I replace that eyes sensor with camera sensor? Camera is okay, right? I'll try to have some camera with me. Okay. Have you seen surveillance system in our college, RJKD Barsad? There are some cameras, right? Yeah, what are those cameras? Will they get data in night time also? When there is darkness, will it get data? With the help of the existing surveillance cameras in our college, can we see in dark also? Is it possible or not? Yes, right. Okay, yes, that's fine. Yes means. Yeah, how that can be possible? Is any guess? Without light also, they can have the picture, rough picture of the objects. How that's possible? Yeah, that's possible because that's taking the help of IR, infrared range also, IR cameras. That led to collect that temperature variations in the environment. That's what that is going to do. Your visible light camera is there, right? That will try to collect that light intensity variations, and this IR camera will try to collect that temperature variations, that thermal variations, thermal picture of that environment. And each and every object, they might try to provide a different temperatures, or there might be variations in temperature across that object also. It will try to grab that opportunity in order to have that picture format even in the darkness also, with the help of IR camera, infrared camera. Yeah, that's fine. It means they will work very well even in the dark time also, right? It means as compared to this person, suppose there is a darkness at this point of time, there is some darkness here and there is no light at all. The lights of this car are not working at all. Then they may not sense this car, right? There is no light for these cars. But your IR camera can sense that one. Your visible camera can sense in the morning time. That's okay. There's no issue with that one. But your IR camera can sense during darkness also. That's extra benefit we are going to get for that robot, right? As compared to humans. Yeah. Okay, that's fine. Here, the brain is the processor. Once your eyes collected these pictures or this data from the environment, your brain will act like a processor. It will like to process and it will like to give the result. Like, let's say, car, and that is coming roughly with very high speed, or that's coming with low speed. Such data will be given by your processor. Here the processor is nothing but brain, your brain, human brain. Then what is the equivalent to human brain for a robot? Yeah, what is the equivalent to human brain? Equivalent to eyes is camera. Then what is the equivalent system to human brain? What should be that one? Is it a memory or is it a processor or combination of both? Okay, which one is responsible for computations? Brain is doing computations. Similarly, the processor will take care of computations, right? Your sensor means camera or that IR sensor, you're trying to collect the data and the data will be given to processor. And there will be some predefined algorithm or some program, some learning algorithm, well-trained learning algorithm, which will try to classify the objects. Yeah, that's what we are doing there. Everything will be done with the help of digital signal processor, all these processings. The data will be collected by camera system and the collected data will be processed with the help of digital signal processor. You can have a look into this one. And he's a blind person, he can't see the environment properly, but he can listen. He has hearing system. There is no issue with hearing system. He has problem with the eyes. Then what they are doing is they are trying to have some specs like this one. And you can try to attach a camera system. If you want, you can have that IR camera also. During darkness also they can see, right? That IR camera. And the concerned data will be processed with the help of some processor. Some processor will be there in this entire system, and that processor will try to process the things digitally. Finally, that can be converted into audio. That's given to this earphones as an audio. This picture is converted, for example, there's a dog. That will be converted into audio. There is a dog like that one, and that will be conveyed to this through the ears. That's what happening here. And some other fine details also there. We can have a look into this later. For example, you can try to read the bus numbers also with the help of OCR. OCR means optical character recognition system. First, that will try to take the picture of that bus, and after that, that will try to extract that number plate in that one. That plate will be there, right? That bus number region will be there. That will try to go to that region, and once that gone to that region, it will try to extract the numbers, and that numbers will be converted into audio later. The text to speech conversion, and that data will be given to earphones. In that manner, it will be helpful for you, right? Digital signal processing. And this is the object recognition task. This will come under computer vision. Computer vision. For example, if you take the picture with the digital camera, and that data is given to some system processor with well-trained algorithm, which can classify the objects in that picture. In this case, this trying to classify this as car, this as a dog, horse, person, and one more person like that. Everything is done with the help of a computer. No human being is trying to mark this one. That is totally processed with the help of your digital signal processor. Yeah, all this thing is possible because of that deep neural networks. You might, yeah, have heard about the term machine learning, deep learning, or artificial intelligence. Yeah, anyone of you? Can you try to respond? I heard about these terms, artificial intelligence. Okay, you heard about that, right? This can be done, this object classification can be done with the help of deep neural network, and special structure for that one is CNN, convolutional neural networks. It got very famous most recently only. Just from the past 6 to 7 years, this became so popular. This convolutional neural networks. Can you have a look into this later? Have you heard about Amazon's Alexa speech recognition system? Can someone answer what Alexa is going to do? You might heard about Alexa, right? See, you might heard about Alexa or Hi Siri, or you might heard about okay, Google, such things, right? Some commands, at least one of them you might heard, right? Yeah. They'll try to recognize the speech, right? They'll try to recognize the speech. For example, if you ask like, hey, Alexa, can you play a song for me? Then that will try to understand what you are speaking. And accordingly, that will try to react. They'll try to play a song. This is a speech recognition task will be done with the help of that digital processor once again. And there, that's possible all because of that machine learning or deep learning algorithms. Recurrent neural networks, that's so popular for speech recognition, RNN. For computer vision case, to recognize the objects in the picture, CNN, convolutional neural network. For speech recognition task, RNN is more famous, recurrent neural networks. And there are some more developments over that one. That's a trending one in deep learning. I'll ask later some questions. Which one is easy for computer and which one is easy for humans? Try to write some task. Okay. Yeah, which one is easy for computer out of these two tasks as compared to humans? First one or second one? Which one will you, okay, first one, right? First one is very easy for computer as compared to humans. This task is much easy for your digital signal processor. The computer is nothing but digital signal processor only, right? It's some basic version of this one is calculator. Calculator, right? Okay, that's fine. This is easy for computer as compared to human being. Then what about speech recognition system? Is it easy for computer as compared to humans? Is it easy or tough? Okay, I'll ask a question. Suppose your mother or your father call you through mobile phone from some unknown number. Can you recognize their voice? Let's assume that they have not introduced about themselves. They just called you. Yeah. Yes, right? Yeah, how you are able to recognize the things? Actually, that's a very complicated task for a computer. It's not so easy. But you can try to analyze the things very easily as compared to computers. The things related to perception, the other things related to perception. The things related to perception can be naturally done by human beings so easily as compared to human being, as compared to the computers. The computers required lot of training in order to do the same task. That's almost very, very difficult task for computer. Nowadays, that's somewhat feasible for the computers. They are trying to do the things up to that level with the help of deep learning algorithms, up to some level. But you need rigorous training for the computers in order to do the same task. But as a human being, you can do the things very, very easily. The things related to perception. Perception means, for example, if you show around 5 to 10 dogs to a kid, 2 years kid, for example, a 2 years kid is there, we show him, this is dog, like that, around 5 to 10 dogs. And if a new dog came, he or she can easily recognize that new dog. They can simply say that it's also a dog. That's very easy with very, very less training. Just by looking into 5 or 10 dogs, that kid is able to learn the things so easily related to perception. But for computer, that's not so easy task. The computer might require order of few thousands of dog images in order to learn that's a dog. Otherwise, that can't understand if some new dog came, that can't simply say that this is a dog. That required that much rigorous training, that computer. But for human beings, that's easy task. The tasks which are related to perception. For example, speech recognition task is also very easy for humans as compared to computers. And biometry or fingerprint recognition system. This can be done easily with the help of a computer as compared to humans, right? Humans, it's not so easy to compare across crores of thumb impressions, right? I want to identify a thief or I want to identify some criminal. I can't simply cross-check across all crores of people, right? It's not so easy task for the human beings. But with the help of a digital signal processor, using some sort of processing, that can be done little bit easily. And face recognition system, iris recognition system can be developed with the help of digital signal processors. Yes, let's come into our subject. Okay, shall you take a break for 5 minutes? Is it okay or shall we continue?
Continue, sir.
Okay, yeah, that's fine. Yeah, what is a signal?
Signal is a single valued function which passes information.
Yes, which is try to convey information, right? Signal corresponds to something which conveys information. It's simply a function. You can call signal like some function. For example, if you consider speech signal as a one-dimensional signal, 1D signal, which corresponds to air pressure variation as a function of time. Air pressure variations as a function of time, that is a speech signal. You might have speech signal like this. This is time versus x of t. This is some function of time. One dimensional signal. And what about image? Is it 1D or 2D? Image is a two-dimensional signal.
Hello.
Which will try to represent brightness as a function of 2D space. XY coordinates you require, right? You require X, Y coordinates in order to represent each and every pixel in your image. Image will be like this. Let's say this is X coordinate, see Y coordinate, and there will be some pixels, right? For digital image, you are going to have pixels. And you need to represent the intensity of each and every pixel, light intensity of each and every pixel, and brightness of this pixel. That's what you are going to say, right? Let's say X, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, Y, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. This corresponds to intensity, I of X means 1, Y means 2, right? I of 1, comma 2. Intensity at 1 comma 2, spatial location 1 comma 2, xy coordinates, right? When coming to images, there's a 2D signal which corresponds to brightness as a function of 2D space. And video is a 3D signal which represents brightness as a function of 2D space and time. 2D space means xy coordinates, followed by time. Across time also, the pixel value will change at that location, right? That's why you are calling it like a 3D signal, including time, this is 3D. And let's have a look into some types of signals. Continuous time signals are analog signals. Yeah. Can you briefly explain what are the different types of signals? Classification of signals.
Analog and digital signals.
Okay, analog, digital, right? Continuous. I'll try to call this like digital. Analog signals will be continuous in both time and amplitude. This will be continuous both time and amplitude. This is continuous. What about digital signals? Discrete in both time and amplitude. And one more thing is there in between. This is continuous time signals. Then discrete time signals are there. Can you guess what the meaning of discrete time signals? Discrete in time. They are discrete in time. They are discrete in time. But they are continuous in amplitude. Those are called as discrete time signals. They can be continuous in amplitude. Those are called as discrete time signals. Some of the digital signals are as follows. For example, if you consider audio recording or that voice recording, analog pressure wave is sampled and converted to one-dimensional discrete time signal. After that, that's converted into binary form and that will be stored in memory. Binary corresponds to digital. Binary is one of the format for digital signals. And photos, if you consider digital images, the analog scene of light is sampled using CCD array, charge coupled devices array, and stored as a two-dimensional discrete space signal. Then text messages are represented with collections of characters. Each is assigned a standard 16-bit number and those are stored in sequence. Okay, if that is a 16-bit number, how many possible characters are there? Can you answer this? Yeah, before going to that, let's consider 2-bit. We have only two possible things. I want to represent my data with the help of 2 bits. Each of them can take either 0 or 1. 0 or 1. Two possibilities for each of these bits. Then how many combinations are possible total?
Four.
Four, right? 00, 01, 1011. Implies four possibilities. If I have three such blanks, and once again I go for binary format, 0 or 1, then how many possibilities are there?
Eight possibilities, sir.
Eight possibilities, right? 2^3. That is called 8 possibilities. Now, my standard for characters is 16 digit or 16 bit number 0101 or 0R1. Total 16 such blanks are there. Then how many possible characters will be there? 2^16, right? 2^16. You can have a look into this. This is a standard. In general, we try to follow this standard. 16-bit number for a character. For example, letter A represented by some 16-bit number, 16-bit number sequence, right? And letter D represented by some 16-bit number, some other 16-bit number. And digit 1 represented by some 16-bit number. And digit 7 represented by some 16-bit number, like that. Yeah, total 0 to 9. 10 possible digits, right? 0 to 9. And you have characters A to Z, 26. That too, you are having lowercase characters, 26, uppercase characters, 26. And there are some other formats, and there are some other symbols, mathematical symbols like epsilon, sigma, integration, such symbols are there, right? Each and every symbol can be assigned with different unique code, unique 16-bit code. For example, all zeros can be represented by letter A. First 15 zeros, next one is 1. That corresponds to letter B, capital letters. Like that, you can try to have such thing. Then what is the rough value for this? 2 power 16 means how much? 2 power 6 into 2 power 10. You see 1024, right? 2 power 10 means 1024. This is roughly 10 power 3. Roughly 10 power 3 into 2 power 6 means 64, right? You might have roughly 64,000. Actually, this is more than 64,000 because this will be 1024 into 64. You have greater than 64,000. That many unique symbols or unique characters you can try to represent with the help of a 16-bit string. That many unique symbols you can assign with the help of a 16-bit string or sequence. It's a standard we are going to use. That's very huge, right? 64,000. You might have some Arabic letters. You might have, yeah, so many such things, right? In those 64,000. Because see, alphabets and digits, they are just very less number, right? 26 lowercase, 26 uppercase, 52, plus 0 to 9, 10 possible digits, followed by some symbols, mathematical symbols, such things. There's so much vacancy to fit so many symbols, right? Mathematical symbols. Each symbol can be assigned with different code, 16-bit code. And one more thing, ratings. For example, if you consider online books, Goodreads and movies, Netflix kind of thing, there will be some rating, right? Like 1-star rating, 2-star rating, up to 5-star rating. We will try to assign rating like 1-star or 2-star, 3-star or 5-star. That's also digital in nature, right? We are trying to assign some numbers to them. And each number will be mapped to some 16-bit, right? 16-bit sequence. Okay, what is the purpose of signal processing? Okay, in our video lecture number 2, we have seen something, right? Some audio processing we had done. What we had done there? We are taking some noisy audio file. What we did later? We tried to process that with the help of digital signal processor. We'll try to filter that noise, right? We tried to remove that noise up to maximum extent. We try to remove that noise, right? That noise removal can be done. That can be done with the help of this, right? Voice signal processing means, this is one use of signal processing. Signal processing is used to enhance signal quality. For example, if that got corrupted by some noise, at least that out of band noise part can be removed with the help of filters, digital filters, right? That denoising, that's called as denoising or filtering. Or we may wish to separate two or more signals that have been combined by some operation. For example, addition, multiplication, convolution. Okay, can you justify this? Can you try to give an example for each of the three operations? Addition, multiplication, and convolution. Addition, for example. Yeah. Okay, have you started reading about modulation in analog and digital communications course? Is it started? Modulation.
Yes, sir. Amplitude modulation.
Yes, it started, right? What is the purpose of modulation? You might studied the purpose of modulation, right? Yeah. What is the purpose of modulation? There are two advantages with that. Main advantages. One is we can transfer them easily, and second one, if you want to radiate the signal, what we are going to do is we'll try to convert that signal to high frequency signal with the help of some high frequency modulator carrier, with the help of carrier signal, and after that we can try to transmit that data. You can try to radiate that with the help of antenna system, right, into the free space, that wireless medium. That can be easily done when that is in high frequency range. For that purpose, we are trying to modulate. That's one reason. What can be the another reason? I heard about multiplexing this term, at least multiplexing. I heard about this. Okay, have you heard about the term multiplexing there?
No, sir.
Okay, yeah, I'll try to give the brief of this one. Okay, what I am going to do is, for example, I'll try to consider two speech signals. One is mine, another one is some other person. Let's consider person one's speech signal is some x1 of t. He trying to speak something, and this corresponds to person 2, some x2 of t. Okay, are you following m of t or x of t notation for message signal?
M of t.
Okay, let me go with the same notations. I don't want to confuse you. M1 of t is the message signal or speech signal delivered by person 1. Is the speech signal delivered by person 2. What I am going to do is, I will try to modulate this with a carrier, for example, 1 megahertz carrier. Some AM modulation or DSBSC, whatever is comfortable for you. I will try to modulate this with a carrier of 2 megahertz. See my FC1, see my FC2. And I will try to radiate both those EM signals, electromagnetic signals, into the same free space or into the same location. Through the same channel, I am broadcasting both of them. And I want to receive one of them at the receiver. For example, if I use antenna at my receiver, what I am going to receive is the combination of both. M1 of t cos 2 pi FC1T, where FC1 equals to 1 megahertz, plus let's consider DSBSC modulation. This is DSBSC modulation. AM without carrier. Hey, there is no carrier for this. That's it. M2 of T cos 2 pi F2T. this what I am receiving at my receiver. If I use an antenna at my receiver, I am going to receive the combination of both, because one person broadcasted this signal into the free space, another person broadcasted this into the free space. It means both of these signals are there in that particular space, right? Now if I try to collect this signal, one out of them, with the help of an antenna, I am going to get both the combination, m1 of t cos 2 pi fc t plus m2 of t cos 2 pi fc 2 into t. I will have to receive both. Can I remove this part? Is it possible? Let's say my space signal is band limited up to 3.5 kilohertz. 3.5 kilohertz. Then what will be this after modulation? Let's consider fc1 equal to 1 megahertz, means 10 power 6 hertz, or in terms of kilohertz, 1000 kilohertz. Yes, what will be this after modulation, DSPSC? What is the spectrum? This will be shifted to center frequency will be 1 megahertz, right? 1000 kilohertz center frequency. And this will be 1000 plus 3.5 kilohertz. 1003.5 kilohertz. And this corresponds to 1000 minus 3.5 kilohertz. This gap is 3.5 kilohertz. Similarly, you can have this on the negative side of that replica of this, because it's a real signal. We have symmetry in the spectral domain. This is my signal one component. What happens to my signal two? Yeah, one of you can answer. What will be the spectrum for my signal two? Okay, what will be the spectrum to my signal 2? The signal 1. Signal 2 spectrum will be, is fc2 equals to 2 megahertz, right? It's a 2000 kilohertz. You might have somewhere here. This is 2000 kilohertz. This is 2000 kilohertz plus 3.5. This is 2000 kilohertz minus 3.5. Like this, you might have this side also, replica of that one. Now, I want to extract only this part. How can I extract? Yeah, how that is possible? Someone already answered, right? I can do with the help of a filtering, right? I can do that task with the help of filtering. I can simply go for some sort of band pass filter. I'll try to remove this component. I'll try to get only this part. Suppose if I want to listen to only second part, what I can do is I can apply band pass filter with these cutoff frequencies. I can remove this part and I can select only this part. I can use some other band pass filter, right? Which can remove this and which can allow only this part. After that antenna. Okay, after that I need to get back to my signal m1 of t. How can I get back to this? See, after this filtering I got only first component, let's say cos 2 pi fc 1 t. I got this one. Now I want to extract my actual message signal. How to do this? Okay, yeah, you are at the starting of that course, right? I can go for coherence demodulation. I'll write multiply with the same carrier, for example, synchronous carrier. Then what will be this expansion? What is this multiplication? M1 of t Yeah, what is cos square theta? One plus cos 2 theta by 2, right? This can be written as 1 plus cos 2 pi into 2 theta means 4 pi, right? I am writing that 2 inside of this one. T divided by 2. M1 of t by 2 plus M1 of t cos 2 pi 2f1 t divided by 2. And the spectrum of this will be M1 of t by 2 spectrum will be somewhere between minus 3.5 kilohertz to 3.5 kilohertz. And this spectrum will be 2f1 corresponds to 2 into 1 megahertz. This is 2000 kilohertz, right? I am going to get somewhere here 2000 kilo. The 2000 minus 3.5. 2000 plus 3.5. Now I can simply go for filter. This implies m of t by 2. Just attenuated version of my signal m of t. If I want, I can amplify this with 2, right? I can apply this to amplifier so that I can get back to my actual sounding m of t. That's what I'm going to do. What I am doing here is, if I want to extract my person one speech, I am applying bandpass filter first and removing this part. And once I got this one, I want to demodulate that. I want actual baseband signal M1 of T. For that, I am doing coherence demodulation, multiplying with this carrier. And if you simplify this, I am going to get a baseband spectrum and some bandpass spectrum with center frequency 2fc1. I'll try to remove this with the help of low pass filter. It's a low pass filter. Then I'm going to get m of t by 2, followed by amplifier. Then I'm going to get m of t. That's what I'm doing. Yeah, this can be done, right? This kind of processing can be done with the help of digital signal processor also. It's possible. There is no doubt at all. Whatever we have done, everything with the help of analog system, but you can try to remember that this can be converted into digital form, right? Replace T with NTS. Replace T with NTS. Sampled version of this carrier. And replace this T with NTS. It means what I am going to do is, I will try to collect this data from my environment with the help of antenna. After that, I will try to sample this data with certain sampling rate, FS. FS should be at least twice the highest frequency of this whole signal. After sampling, I can try to multiply with discrete cosine signal. See, before that I'll do digital filtering. I'll remove this part with the help of digital filter. After that, I'll try to multiply this with cos omega c1t, cos omega c1n, digital frequency, right? Replace t with nts. After that, this will become like cos omega c1 into n, small n. In that way, I can demodulate with the help of digital signal processor also. You don't require that analog multiplier and all those things. It's possible with the help of sampling. After that, you can get the help from processor in order to demodulate that one. All that's possible. That's what we are doing, right? If something is added, if two signals are added, we are going to separate one out of those two signals when they are occupying different frequency bands. With the help of digital filters, that's possible, right? Here we are done with analog filters, but this can be possible with the help of digital filters also. This multiplication term is there, right? For example, in the same context, we can see that here M1 of T multiplied with carrier. Now we want to remove this part and we want to get back to only this part. This part can be extracted from this part using this operation into cos omega C1 into M. From there, you can apply low pass filter, digital low pass filter. In that way also we can proceed, right? Yeah, that's what we are doing. If that got corrupted somehow by addition of noise or with some multiplication operation by some signal, that can be extracted back with the help of digital system, right? Or if that got corrupted by convolution. Corrupted by convolution means you might have seen that equalization, right? In our early lectures, we have seen some input signal x of t passed through some channel. It's an impulse response of that LTA system or channel, some multipath channel. Due to this channel, instead of receiving x of t, I am receiving x of t linear convolution with h of t. But I want my actual x of t at the receiver. This can be done with the help of inverse system, HI of t, where h of t convolution with HI of t should be equals to delta of t. If I am able to do this one, then I can get back to my signal x of t, right? This is inverse system. I can design inverse system accordingly. It's some sort of deconvolution, right? Indirectly. These things can be done with the help of your digital signal processor. This one. When you consider digital systems. And one more thing is signal processing can be used for information extraction and interpretation. For example, speech recognition talks in Alexa or computer vision task. Computer vision means identifying whether there is a dog or whether there is a car in that picture or not with the help of a computer. These tasks can be done with the help of our digital signal processor. And this is what digital signal processing means. Digital signal processing deals with transformation of signals that are discrete in both time and amplitude. Okay, it's already 1 hour, right? Okay, let's stop the session here. Okay, do you have any doubts?